Time, because we have quite a number that we need to cover, almost 97 of them. So we're trying to move as quickly as we possibly can, appreciating that. Let's welcome, as we are starting to give the awards, Mr. Mboweni Mai, Chango Speaker, Dr. Nzinzondola. Thank you so much for joining us. We're now going to team should be ready now with the certificates, and I'm going to call them as quickly as I possibly can in order to move in time. Ross Jenner, Dr. Kennedy Ubaiwa, Etunela Malamba, Gift Chere, Fungari Malipei, Francis Moto, Herbert Njonga, Elvis Kitsungo. This is the first batch. If this could please stand, these are the first ones of the Edu Parents Initiative. Ladies and gentlemen, they deserve a big round of applause for the great work they are doing. I don't think we have done enough in saying thank you to them. Once again, a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. That was the first batch. Thank you so much for the great work that you are doing. The second batch is Solomon Womendo, Augustine Masanu, William Chimene, Pilani Nyatanza, Domen Tata, Eric Marikopo, Emilia Atendi, Gertrude Kangazi, William Mataranyika, Modesta Marasha, Admaya Depende, Justice Matambo, and Fidelia Gandia. That's the next batch. Can you please stand? We want to applaud you. Thank you so much. They deserve a bigger and better round of applause indeed. Thank you. Thank you so much. Even if the ushers do not identify where you are, your certificate will be ready. It will be available for you. The next batch is Teresa Nyemba, Tinashe Shai, Tamuka Sanyika, Ngoni Katsamba, Charity Mofana, Rangamandaza, Tafatwa Sitole, Paida Mutengerere, Aleta Majira, Rebecca Chibana, Tinashe Mutziviri, Persuade Chiwinda, Rupapato Maposa, Sympathy Makururu, Tendai Mashile, Nyarazo Shambira. This is the next batch. Where are you? Thank you so much. A big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. That's my time. They are making a difference that there is. And in the process of doing so, we are appealing to those who are not educated parents as indicated. This is a recruitment time. What you do is you raise your hand, a form will be given to you, you complete, and you then get the assignment of who has to be taken care of. This is a foundation and not an NGO. And as a result, these are not donations, but it's a commitment that will help those that are still on the waiting list as we go. That's the batch that has gone by. The next batch is Raymond Chimpakacha, James Chikwashira, Daniel Amandishe, Munyarazi Matiwa, Maya Tafilenika, Memory Shamanu, Chati Munyarazi, Brian Mutindori, Nyasha Zavame, Lois Zengeni, Titi Dawana, Munyarazi Manenji, Kundai Chivunga, Tadekile Dube, Nyarai Moyo, Tinotenda Kandare, Delight Magadza, Sungano Rusere, Robson Maramba, Rubizai Matarutse, Dadirai Matsima, Gladys Mvumira, Susan Mashiri, Shorai Ndanga, Monica Tonozai, Cynthia Nikobai Me, I think that's correct, Patrick Mamirakiza. This is the other page that we have. Can you please stand? We applaud you. We thank you. We appreciate you wherever you are. The team will move around with the wonderful power. Looking at the applaud they have been given, the show Mateta Wetzir. Please remain standing so that the ushers can identify where you are, those that we have mentioned. If you you've taken your seat, please stand up so that they can see where you are and they can quickly come through with your certificate. We're doing this in the interest of our time, of course. We could have called everyone up to the top, but in the interest of time, we want to manage our time as we have so many of us. These are the ones that we are celebrating. Their names are rolling on the screen. You believe, as Mr. Madibe indicated, your name is not there. We are calling it out over here. So we appreciate you in a way. When the cameraman comes through, smile into that. You may be in the newspaper tomorrow, you never know. First page with your smile. Absolutely fantastic. That's it. It's greatly appreciated. The work that you are doing is sterling, making a difference in so many lives as we go by. The ushers are moving by and making sure that you get your certificates. Your standing is greatly appreciated. Don't be ashamed of it. We are actually admiring the debate in so indeed, these are the people who are doing it, and our ushers are moving by to give you the certificates. And here we go. Indeed, we go on to the last batch that we have here. We have Isidora Nikipaye, Nisi Mpaye, Joseph Mafara, Reseli Siletso, Sepe Lane, Reseli Sitoe, Sepe Lane. You may. Francis Moketi, Sefali, Kelebon Kasake, John Muyambo, I took a mission. To the Leboli, you, this is nice. And this is the best section of it all. Indeed, may you please stand from wherever you are. We want to applaud you. Indeed. Wonderful to be. Thank you so much. They are receiving, and we appreciate it. Indeed, this is an appeal that if you are not an aged parent, please, this is the time that we are appealing to you to take up this responsibility to sponsor the children that are vulnerable, that are out there. These are the names of those that have received. All in all, we are very grateful. More than 90 of them that are doing a sterling job out there to support the vulnerable children. Let's give them a big round of applause once again. Thank you. Now we go. And this is the Higher Life Foundation Performance Best Awards. It's the next that we are now. We'll be calling upon Mr. I. Magaya and Mr. F. Gandia to come over to the certificates to those that we're going to call upon. I'll read a bit of citation over here and then call the winner. The High Life Foundation Values Award is for a person in the organization that embodies Higher Life Foundation values, accountability, and is an executor. This individual was voted by all Highlight Foundation staff in Zimbabwe, South Africa, Lesotho, Burundi, across, battled out both senior and junior. In this category, the winner is, and the award goes to Tigere Ndawaya. Excelled in their own work throughout the financial year 2016 to 2017. The winner was voted for and singled out from fellow colleagues in the education department, and that includes quality of education, lifelong development, and access to education pillars. Consideration was given to the way they have driven with zero usage, access, participation in young and dynamic among other things. This award goes to Ranga Mandas. Exceptional individual performance in education, Tigere Ndawaya. Monica Kondotai. Solomon Omendo. And Rebecca Kibraya. Congratulations, Makoro Koto. Well done. We salute you for the great work that you are doing. Well done. Well done. Well done. Congratulations. Beautiful. Great work that's been done, and we appreciate it. The next category, ladies and gentlemen, is Exceptional Individual Performance Award Operations. This award category is for staff in operations that have consistently excelled in their work throughout the financial year 2016-2017 as service providers to the programming that the foundation is involved in. Selection is based on the individual's ability to clearly demonstrate professionalism, diligence, and integrity, as well as service provider. This individual was voted for by all Higher Life Foundation staff in Zimbabwe and battled it out with 150 employees of senior and junior staff. This award goes to Munyala Tutabeta. Consistently excelled in their work throughout the financial year 2016-2017. The winner was voted for by all Lesotho staff members. Consideration was given to the way they have driven receivable usage, access, participation in young and dynamic, among other things. This award goes to Tesha Moketi. I should come from that country. Well done. Fantastic. Now we'll move on to the next category, which is the Exceptional Individual Performance Award Burundi. This award category is for Burundi staff that has consistently excelled in their work throughout the financial year 2016 to 2017. The winner was voted for by all Burundi staff members. Consideration was given to the way they have driven to zero usage, access, participation in young and dynamic, among other things. The award goes to Joseph Outstanding Support Department in Operations. The winning department was voted for by 150 staff members, and selection was based on the department's responsiveness as a service provider, professionalism, and the department's contribution to the attainment of the Higher Life Foundation Big Airy
audacious goal. This award goes to Communications and Strategic Partnerships. Education. This award goes to the most outstanding social business unit in education. The winning SBU was voted by 150 staff members, and consideration was given to the way they have driven zero usage, access, participation in young and dynamic, among other things. This award goes to Mashona Land West. And we'll get back with the second tower audience that are giving out tonight. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's give Tari Ronegi Tari once again big round of applause. Tari, she does it with the full band, acoustic guitar, whichever way she gives us entertainment. Thank you.
Thank you. Foundation, besides being the CEO of Ebonet Wireless in Zimbabwe. And then in the next category, we are going to honor Liquid Telecom. Liquid Telecom has helped us with support of a technical nature as well as of a financial nature. They've helped us with connectivity, data connectivity, networking, the bandwidth that we use in our offices, as well as for our project with Zio, has been made possible by Liquid Telecoms. They've also offered support for some of our foreign students that are in Waterford College, and for that we are truly grateful. So ladies and gentlemen, help me to put our heads together to receive this award on behalf of Liquid Telecom. I'm going to call a representative of Liquid in here to come up to the front. If there's none, I'm going to ask Mr. Denimara to please kindly come up and receive the award. Do we have a representative of Liquid here this evening? Thank you, sir. Students, and they put together a package where some of their staff will actually come through graduates, undergrads, and they're also going to help some of them actually intern within their organization. So, by affording or offering them a certificate of recognition from Higher Life Foundation. The big question is, who are going to ask to represent them? We have a representative of Kwese TV this evening. Mr. Mowendi, the popular demand, we'd like you to kindly come and receive the award from Kwese TV Foundation. We just took that out. So let's give an applause, a round of applause to Kwese. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Mr. Madibe, for taking us through that category. We're going to do an skit on Back by Chieza Diva Guru in the house. This is a skit that we have to see the Diva Guru doing it right there. The Diva Guru is in the house. Give a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen.
In a collision of culture, his place of history was misconstrued. Insecurity, inferiority, dependency, and despondency had become the norm. He had learned and grasped the principle of substitution. What he considered complicated was safely replaced by an inferior, less complex alternative. Good evening to you all. My name is Chieza Diva Guru, a finance manager at the Higher Life Foundation. I am an alumni of Africa University, part of the first fruits of the Joshua Nkomo Scholarship Fund. My mother comes from Lesotho, as can be evidenced by my attire, and a special welcome to people from Lesotho. And my late father was Zimbabwean. I present to you the African child. 7-year-old John sits on a substitute of a bicycle. A wooden block with two sticks dug onto the sides to make the pedals. A substitute, indeed, to the more complicated, expensive, mobile bicycle. Tapiwa's clothes can clearly be called rags and are smudged with mud. His head has not felt a comb for ages. Tapiwa merrily rides his bicycle, a joyous smile plastered on his face. Inexplicable contentment. But the bicycle is not moving. It is stationary. A substitute, indeed, to the more complicated, expensive, mobile bicycle, which would rather move you from point A to B. As Tapiwa grows up, he carries the substitution mentality with him, and so do more generations of Africa. So who then gets Africa moving? Kenya's James Chikwati states that the majority of Africans today are poorer than those who lived in the Stone Age era. And this means that today's Africans ought to drive their own age of enlightenment by asking such basic questions as to why a continent rich in minerals is perceived to be poorer than the rest of the world. For more than two decades, governments and development agencies have focused on reducing poverty. There have been advances, but progress has been uneven. One of the major challenges still faced in Africa is lack of access to quality education. with over 34 million children out of school in 2016, according to a UNESCO education report. Yet, like a pure scenario, we ride the wooden bicycle, satisfied but stagnant. Ladies and gentlemen, as the Higher Life Foundation, we are happy to say that through our work, we are going to take on the mobile bicycle. We choose not to go for the wooden bicycle, which is stationary, but we choose to aim for the more complex stuff through the various platforms that we have. Technology is wealth. With Facebook's 115 billion market cap on its IPO day, Mark Zuckerberg created wealth nearly equivalent to half of Nigeria's GDP. Today, with the same Facebook, we have witnessed the democratization of media with the rise of on social media. Company brands are being created on social media. Mentorship beyond geographical borders is being done on through Dr. Strive Masiwa's mentorship platform on Facebook. He emphasized that children are the ones that will generate new age ideas today, and that children should be exposed to technology. A focus on quality of education and short education solutions for Africa from the get-go. Today is a joyous moment for me as a direct product of the Higher Life Foundation, who is now part of this great vision of impacting 2 million leaders by 2020. Ladies and gentlemen, the Higher Life Foundation, through platforms such as Rezivo, is creating history, empowering the African child with the tool to change the world, recognizing the need to do that with a focus on technology. The late Nelson Mandela once said that education is the most powerful tool which can be used to change the world. Now, if education is the most powerful tool, then undoubtedly, technology is the catalyst platform to drive accelerated access to education to the over 34 million masses. Other exciting organizations such as taken a step further by taking education and technology to early childhood development. I asked a question, gets Africa moving? The Higher Life Foundation will get Africa moving. Simba Education will get Africa moving. Muzinda Hub will get Africa moving. Econet Wireless Group will get Africa moving. And you and I will and should get Africa moving by association. The Higher Life Foundation continues to create opportunities for us to participate in the transformation of lives through platforms such as EduParent, and the onus really is on us. My message today is clear. As the Higher Life Foundation, we're putting an end to the substitution mentality that has long lingered amongst the African children. Education, digital education in Africa is possible. Our children will no longer be confined to learning from textbooks only, nor will they be affected by geographical dispersion. Our systems and structures are hinged upon sustainable pillars we have built, such as lifelong development, systems that provide effective mentorship borders around technology, systems and structures that can stand the test of time and continue to create a ripple effect for the next generation. In conclusion, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to encourage us as the Higher Life Foundation team that indeed we're able to impact over 2 million leaders by 2020. Difficult as this may seemingly be, it can be done, and it shall be done. We are not those that better off, treat them. And most importantly, we do know that with God, all things are possible. Thank you.
That's a big round of applause. Yes, honestly, it's inspiring. Thank you so much. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to the category, the Long Service Awards category, and we'll be calling upon Mr. I. Frankier, the Long Service Awards, the High Life Foundation. Long Service Award recognizes dedicated staff who have served the organization and has been diligently for some time. This award recognizes staff loyalty and commitment to the work and has spent 15 years, 10 years, and 5 years of service. This is the, we start with the 15 years category, and the 15 years with Susan Mashini, IT. Susan Mashini. Well done.
so fast. Followed by Europa Fight Women for IT. Europa Paso. There she comes. 5 years of service. Well done. Followed by Tawanda Magwabe, the Administration Department. Followed by the Nakwashi Kitchen and the Central Post of Policy and Advocacy. Well done. Appreciate your long service, dedication to duty. It is followed by Samuel Quimby, IT Department. Well done. Last but not least, Moselisi Sefali, the Social Business Unit. Well done. Moselisi Sefali, the Social Business Unit. Congratulations, Makoro Koto. That brings us to the end of that category. Thank you so much to our presenters. Tani Monedi Tare is in the house to give us another stint of entertainment. Then we go to the last of the categories that we have. Tariro, over to you. Thank you.
Drink. Now to tell my drink. Boy, drink and a four.